Hello and Happy New Year to all shippers of lithium batteries and cells and everyone out there planning or hoping to ship them in 2024. I'm Roger with Lion Technology, and in this video, we're talking what you need to know to ship lithium batteries safely, successfully, and in compliance with U.S. and international regulations this year. First, if you're brand new to shipping lithium batteries, there are four key principles you need a grasp of to do it right. Lion has created an ultimate guide to these four keys that you can grab for free right now from the link in the video description. That guide is packed with important details, especially for beginners, about the types of lithium cells and batteries, watt hour rating, shipping batteries alone versus in or with equipment, and insights for air and ocean shipping. So grab that free ultimate guide so you can refer to those fundamentals anytime you need to this year. Now, here's what lithium battery shippers need to know as we kick off 2024. Let's start at the ground level before we ramp up. Because lithium batteries pose a substantial fire hazard during transportation, they are subject to regulation as hazardous materials, also called dangerous goods. For shippers, that means packages must be prepared according to specific regulations if we want them to be accepted by carriers and transporters, to arrive where they're going safely and without incident, and avoid scrutiny from compliance inspectors along the way. Here's one thing to know about the U.S. and international regulations for shipping hazmat. They're not written in stone. They change frequently and often in major ways. That's especially true for hazmat like lithium batteries, which power a rapidly expanding range of devices, vehicles, and equipment, and about which we're still learning new things all the time. Before we can talk about the most impactful recent updates to those regulations, first, you need to know where to look for them. In the United States, that means starting with the U.S. Department of Transportation's Hazardous Materials Regulations, or HMR. Among other things, the HMR governs every step of the pre-transportation process for hazmat shippers, from classifying your lithium battery for transportation and giving it a name, to choosing packaging, using the required markings and labels, filling out shipping papers accurately, training and retraining employees, and more or less anything else you can think of that needs to get done in order for hazmat to move from here to there. If you ship lithium batteries by air or you plan to this year, you also must comply with additional, more stringent rules imposed by the world's biggest association of air carriers, the International Air Transport Association, or IATA. IATA publishes the Dangerous Goods Regulations, or DGR, so that shippers everywhere have one standard set of regulations to follow to prepare hazmat for transportation by passenger or cargo aircraft. If you want to ship lithium batteries by air, even completely within the United States, you are required to comply with these IATA rules. A new edition of the DGR takes effect on January 1st of each new year. Compliance with the 65th edition is mandatory as of January 1st, 2024. International rules apply to lithium batteries transported on cargo ships, too. To ship by sea, you will need the current edition of the International Maritime Dangerous Goods Code, or IMDG Code. Just like the new IATA regulations, compliance with the 2022 edition IMDG code is mandatory as of January 1st. For a really detailed look at what's changed for lithium battery shippers in recent years, check out our Shipping Lithium Batteries in 2023 video here on the channel, or look at some of the recent news posts linked in the video description. We're talking about regulatory changes that for the most part apply to air shipments only. These include revisions that eliminated exceptions available for some smaller lithium cells and batteries shipped by air, made changes to package markings, added a test summary requirement for manufacturers and distributors, and amended several IATA DGR packing instructions, and others. So if you're coming back to the lithium battery regulations in 2024 after some time apart, or if it's been 2 or 3 years since your last hazmat training that really got into lithium batteries, it's important that you identify recent rule changes that impact what you ship as soon as possible. That way you can update your team's procedures and training to stay in compliance. Speaking of training, U.S. law requires that shippers of hazardous materials like lithium batteries provide training and regular retraining for all employees in job roles that affect hazmat transportation safety. Employers must provide training within 90 days of hire date or job assignment, and new employees may not work unsupervised until that training is complete. Retraining or recurrent training is required every 3 years unless you ship by air, in which case it's required every 2 years by the IATA DGR. If you want to know more about the training required for employees covered by the hazmat regulations, like who needs training, what that training must cover, how to keep records of training, or anything else, check out the hazmat training FAQ page at lion.com. For reliable, up-to-date training to ship lithium batteries by ground, air, or vessel in compliance with US DOT and international regulations in 2024 and beyond, head to lion.com/lithium to browse a variety of courses and learning formats, including the self-paced Shipping Lithium Batteries online course and live instructor-led webinars delivered all year long. Thank you for sticking with me through this video. Don't forget to grab that free ultimate guide to 4 key fundamentals for lithium battery shippers from the link in the video description, especially if this is all new to you. If you like this video, there is a lot more where this came from coming your way in 2024, so hit that like button, subscribe to the channel, check out some of our other lithium battery videos, and I'll see you in the next one.